I'm Courtney Solomon, the director of Getaway. This sequence is really the introduction of one of our main characters, the Shelby Super Snake Cobra GT500. The car starts, and now we start giving you a feel of how this movie's going to go. We introduce to you a bunch of the cameras, which are mounted on the inside and the outside of this car. These were essentially what would be akin to GoPro cameras, except they were a Sony VAL version of such cameras. Very small, little sort of wide-angle lens, only one lens on the camera. With the light that's coming and hitting these lenses, you get a very blown out type of image from them, and you get a very wide sort of fisheye type image from them, you know, which is prominently used in many different spots throughout the movie. There were 7 different types of cameras used. Some of the cameras on the hood of the car are actually iconic cameras. Those are a higher resolution camera. And we also have red cameras in certain shops mounted on the fender of the car and on the back of the car, which gives you a higher resolution image for certain points where we really want you to see something very, very, very clearly. In between all of that, there's actually cameras mounted inside the car. These are more of those Sony VAL cameras, and we actually had 6 of them in the car, one in between the actual steering wheel of the car, one right in front of the gear shift, 3 on the top looking from the right side, left side, and center side of the car, down on Ethan Hawke and eventually Selena Gomez when she gets in the car. But here it's just Ethan Hawke going.
Yeah. On level 2, you will find a very special car. You will know which one. Steal it.
Here we actually show you roughly that there's cameras all over the car, as John Voight explains to us as the voice, that this car has cameras on it. He's watching every move that our hero Brent Magna makes.
Drive it to the top of the city and I will contact you there.
In this particular sequence as well, we had cameras on the police cars that are actually chasing Ethan Hawke so that we could get viewpoints from both looking from behind and seeing them coming towards us. We had red cameras shooting from the outside on all cars going in the chase sequence. And then also we had the VAL type cameras on the top and on the hoods of the police cars themselves.
If you contact the police or if you get caught, she will die.
Average shot was 27 to 42 cameras shooting at the same time. This hadn't been done before in films, not to this sort of degree of insanity.